Well, it may sound like deja vu, it may sound like a joke, but somehow we have still found ourselves at the end of October in 2020 in yet another cone of uncertainty for a tropical system. We have Hurricane Epsilon. I thought it was bad last week having to talk about another hurricane at the end of October, but it's way out there. Now we have to talk about one that's closer to home. And yes, we are in the cone of uncertainty yet again, although I will say that this one doesn't look like hopefully it'll bring extremely significant impacts, as we'll have a few things that will keep it, it looks like, from intensifying a lot. And there's still a lot of uncertainty about where it will end up. As you know, we've been through this 6 times already, and things have changed significantly in the couple of days leading up to the storms. So this is Tropical Depression 28, was named earlier this afternoon at 4 p.m. You can see some showers and some clouds in the area, and some of these higher cloud tops, the whites and grays billowing on the southern side of the system. It has a movement just barely to the north-northwest. It really, though, as I said, will not move all that much in the next day or so. Pressure not too low just yet, but we may see it by tomorrow begin to get winds going a little bit stronger, and that would bring it up to tropical storm status, and this would be Zeta, as I said. So by Monday into Tuesday, it will still be in this general area, but by early Tuesday, it looks like it will be near Yucatan or in the southern Gulf. It moves out over the Gulf of Mexico Tuesday into Wednesday. But just to point out a couple of things, although it says category 1 here in the middle of the Gulf, we will see whether it's able to attain that status and get organized enough to make it to a hurricane or not. In either case, if it does or if it doesn't, it looks like it should be weakening as it moves toward the Gulf Coast in the northern Gulf, because we will have not only the fast movement, we will also have lower water temperatures here because we've had a couple of cold fronts keeping our water temperatures lower. And that was a factor in the past storm that we had with Delta. And then also we'll have a big cold front that we've been talking about moving in as well. So that will increase wind shear before landfall too. So just to point out, look at this huge area where it may eventually make landfall. As we know, this has played a role in every single cone of uncertainty that we've been in this year. Even though we're pretty much right in the middle right now, we will see whether the center track eventually moves to the east or west. And the National Hurricane Center does point out that this path is to the west, actually, of the model consensus, which is a little bit to the east at this point. So we'll see whether that trend happens. Here are the factors that we need to consider, though, getting into the next couple of days. First of all, eventually some high pressure will begin to nudge in here to bring it out into the Gulf. Before that, there won't be a lot of strong steering currents while it's still here in the Northwest Caribbean Sea. Then as we get into the middle of the week, here comes this really strong low pressure area, trough of low pressure, to direct it out to the north and northeast. So once again, we're talking about a similar setup that we've talked about with the past couple of storms, where we're waiting for the high to push it off to the west, and then the trough to eventually bring it to the north and northeast. So a lot depends on the timing and the strength of both of these systems. And it looks like the main impacts, though, would be Wednesday, since that trough will really accelerate it. So it will be fast moving, it looks like. Water temperatures are still high in the Caribbean, but much lower near our coast. So to get into models quickly and show you a couple of solutions, the GFS has low pressure here in the southern Gulf. The GFS really doesn't organize this too much. Wednesday, 4 p.m., here's some rain, but the Euro does organize it a bit more, keeps it a little bit stronger farther to the west. And very important right now to take these models with a grain of salt. We'll have many more of these model runs coming up as we get into the next couple of days. But the Euro does have some rain over us on Wednesday, potentially some heavy rain, and then it moves out. The computer model forecast, as I show you these, moving into the Gulf, taking the turn, and notice a lot of them are displaced off to the east of New Orleans as opposed to the west. So that could be a good thing. That would place us on the side of the storm for our area with fewer impacts. So bottom line, what we know right now, tropical storm tomorrow enters the Gulf Tuesday. Main impacts would be on Wednesday for wherever it makes landfall. That would include rain, possible wind and storm surge. And there's still uncertainty. The error 4 days out, like we are, is 160 miles to the west or to the east. Rain totals, by the way, even with the Euro that did have rain over us, look like maybe 1 to 2 inches at this point, but it's way too early to speculate on that, really. I just wanted to toss that out in case you're interested in seeing that. So today we've actually already had a little front move through. It will be a little less humid tonight and tomorrow. It looks nice and quiet Monday too. Tuesday, we could have a few showers, but Wednesday would be the day with any rain and impacts. And that cold front that's coming is going to set us up for some nice and cooler weather quickly moving in Thursday, setting up things looking nice for Friday into the weekend.
A rough outing for Tulane this afternoon in Orlando as the Green Wave remain winless in conference play. Plus, a COVID update.